Hello all. In this session, Viraga, I am going to explain about energy, same energy sources. In that last PPT, I have explained about solar energy. The same thing under non-conventional energy, this PPT will be on the fuel energy. Okay, that is fuel energy, that is fuel cell. Like I think fuel cell can be defined as an electrochemical cell that generate electrical energy from the fuel via an electrochemical reaction, and these cells require a continuous input of fuel and an oxidizing agent, and also in order to sustain the reactions which generate the electricity, and also therefore these cells can consistently generate electricity until the supply of fuel and the oxygen is cut off. So till that we can use this fuel cells, and every fuel cell compromises of the electrolyte and a catalyst to fasten that reaction rate. Okay, and a single fuel cell can generate a tiny amount of DC electricity. So here we can see types of fuel cells: alkaline fuel cells, phosphoric fuel cells, molten carbonate fuel cells, and solid oxide fuel cells. These are the types of fuel cells. Okay, so first one is alkaline fuel cells. So I'll just come back to this slide, the figure one. I'll just come back to that slide. Alkaline fuel cells, like this type of fuel cells, was introduced in the 1960s. And this was the fuel cell which was used as a primary source of electricity in the space program, actually. Okay, and also these cells have an that alkaline solution which is used to separate a porous matrix, which is in turn used to separate the electrodes. That is a kind of a membrane, okay, kind of a membrane, so which is used to separate that electrodes, and also that operating temperatures of these cells are quite low. That means approximately 90 degree Celsius, and these cells are very much highly efficient, and they also produce heat and water along with the electricity. Now, why fuel cells? Like before going to the next applications, I'm just seeing that why it is essential. That means kind of a uses or an advantages. Does work for both combustion engine, that is chemical energy to electrical energy to mechanical energy, and battery, that is chemical to electrical, but with more efficiency in the longer lifespan. Longer lifespan has no moving parts, therefore no wear and tear. So that is one. And efficiency can be increased if fuel cell incorporates thermal cogeneration. So that is, and also it is very much pollution free, and pure hydrogen is used as a fuel, and the only byproducts are water and the heat. Okay, and the alkaline fuel cells applications, you can see the alkaline fuel cells were firstly used by NASA in the Apollo missions to provide the power as well as to provide the portable water for the astronauts. So the first alkaline fuel is used used to this purpose, and the alkaline fuel cells are most used as they are most efficient, and very much we can say it initial cost is less and also cheap to manufacture. And the alkaline fuel cells is commercially incubated into a 22 seated hydrogen ship, and power assisted by an electric motor that gets into electricity from the fuel cell. So next one, phosphoric fuel cells. Like this is the fuel cells which is involve the use of phosphoric acid as an electrolyte here. So phosphoric acid will play a major role, like an electrolyte, in order to channel the hydrogen. And also that working temperature of these cells lie in the range of like 150 degree Celsius to 200 degree Celsius. And this type of fuel cells is commonly used in commercial cars. And also that electrolyte, like liquid phosphoric, that electrolyte, liquid acid, which is operating the range of 150 to 210 degree Celsius, in between approximately that. And phosphoric acid cells has potential of use in the stationary power generation. And also it operates with high temperature than the polymer exchange membrane. And also because of the high temperature, a phase transition, because of the due to the acidic nature of the electrolyte, the components of these cells tend to, you know, oxidize over time. So that is one feedback about this. And the uses of phosphoric acid. Phosphoric acid fuel cells has been, you know, used for stationary power generators with output in the 100 kilowatt to 400 kilowatt range. And they are also finding application in the large vehicles such as buses and the commercial cars in that vehicles. And India's DRDO, that is developing this phosphoric acid fuel cells for air independent propulsions in their for example in the submarines, they are using the phosphoric acid fuel cells. And the Indian Navy has requested a fully engineered system in 2014. They have used in 2014 fully engineered system from the phosphoric acid fuel cells used. It is in the year 2014. So here you can see the fuel cells, how they are using in the ships or small boats. Hydrogen storage will be different, fuel cell modules will be different, and batteries, power electrons, electric motors. Okay, next one is molten carbonate fuel cells. These fuel cells are also best suited for a large stationary power generators, and also they have operating with lower operating temperature than the solid oxide fuel cells. And this makes a design with little less expensive. That initially cost will be less expensive. And these cells can be powered by carbon based fuel cells and also such as natural gas and biogas. From that also the molten carbonate fuel cells can work. And the anode and the cathode of this cell are vulnerable. That means the corrosion due to high operating temperature and the presence of that carbonate electrolyte. And also this molten carbonate fuel cells will be like relatively high temperature of 650 degrees. And this salt becomes a liquid at high temperatures and enabling the movement of carbonate ions. So that is the difference between the phosphoric fuel cells and the molten carbonate fuel cells. And this is just an explanation of the fuel cell electric technology explained here, how it is used for a car. It is acting like a boost converter because the stack voltage is 650 volt, and that boost converter is used to obtain an output with a higher voltage than the input. And applications, like we have a lot more applications in for the fuel cells. Cleaner and avoid the pollution of marine diesel engines, which currently provide the power in the major major ships, like world's largest ships or warships, that kind. And fuel cell electric vehicles use the clean fuels that are, therefore it is very much eco-friendly and than the internal combustion engine which is based in the vehicles. And they have been used to power many space expeditions, including the Apollo space stations. And also portable of some fuel cells is extremely useful in some military applications, And these electrochemical cells can also use to power several electronic devices as well. And mainly the fuel cells are used as a primary or a backup sources for electricity in the remote areas or in the village areas where there is a lack of electricity. So it can be kept as a backup for electricity. And the last one is solid oxide fuel cells, which I left it. So that's why I have added here. This is one of the most commercially used fuel cells and like operating with highest life. And these cells involve like the use of solid oxide or a ceramic electrolyte, and also that operating temperature of these cells would be lies in the 800 degree Celsius to 1000 degree Celsius. And this is cells are limited to stationary applications due to high operating temperatures. And uses would be it is used as a power generator for residential as well as the commercial purpose. And it is used to power the heavy vehicles like trucks and buses.